today we're looking at the Epson V19 Perfection, and we are going to install this on Linux Mint 18.2. This will work on nearly all Linux operating systems, and we will just check it out today. It's a very light scanner. It's a very beautiful scanner. It's got a nice stand here in the back. Flip it up like this, so you can stand here. I hope you can see it. There we go. So it's very flexible. Let's move it back. And it's very cheap. It's like 80 bucks. US dollars, plus minus, in Russia, where I bought it. So, I bought it for work, for one of the colleagues, we needed a scanner, and she's running Ubuntu Mate 16.4, so I will install it on her computer, with that, and I chose Epson. If it's an obvious choice, I didn't want anything else, because Epson works well with Ubuntu. And they got drivers on the website, like you would choose from between Windows, we will have a look now, or Mac, or Linux, they got them all there. On the box, it doesn't say it supports Linux, which is a pity, but on the website, they make it pretty clear they support Linux, which is awesome, and I want to support companies like that. So, let's plug it in and have a look. So, I got this cable, it's a micro USB, it was given with the box of this one, so let's plug it in. As you would notice when it's plugged in, it will see as nothing has happened. But as we're looking on the side now, you can type in your name here, you can find a link to this in the description of the video. You type in V19, and of course the first one, you look for Linux, and there's Linux, it's awesome. And we take the latest one, we accept the agreement. And we say package download page. And here you can choose between Ubuntu. So as you can see, they got all the latest Ubuntu versions, even 17.4. They got Linux Mint 17 and 18. They got Debian 7 and 8, not 9 yet. They got Fedora, also not 26 yet, but they got like so many and all the worst backing songs. So as in this video, I'm using 18.2 Linux Mint, I will download this package. You can download any package that you need. And let's look at it now. As you can see, it's only 12 megabytes, the package is not very big, which is awesome, I think. And let's open it up. Let's close this. As you can see, here we go, and we just extracted. As you can see, I already got a package like it next to it. But this is the one I just made. As you can see, here is the install package inside. So we open the terminal and write sudo point the slash install in. Press tab to complete the command, type in a password, and let it type it in again. There we go. And let me run it. As you can see here, it's installing another program also for the scanner. Now, the best thing is to do next is to reboot your system. So, I will just reboot it, and I will see you now. Wonderful, and we are back. So now, let's go to our menu, and type in scan. As you can see, the default scanner, simple scan will not work with this printer. Don't ask me why, it just is. But image scan is a program which was automatically installed with the printer, and as you can see, the printer is already getting excited just by the sound of it. So let's quickly put the CD, the driver CD, because we got no need for it, inside of it, because I want this paper. And let's start. So let you scan it. As you can see, what? I don't want the blank one. So I found that it is doing it every time. So you can press refresh, but there's other program also which is scanning. As you can see, it's refreshing everything now because it just follows a blank page for some reason. The scanner makes a bit of noise, but as you can see, there is scanning the page. Which is awesome. And then you can just say scan and voila, you can save it. Let's save it as a PDF or JPEG or anything like this. As you can see, I'm doing it with you. Let's try one more time. If this doesn't work, it's really okay. Xane also works well. I'm just doing it with you, we're checking it together. If we run into errors, we run into it together. Because we are a team. Team Fantastic. So, press and scan, we say save. And don't ask me why it doesn't save that one. Ah, because we refresh it, but now it's scanning for the first time officially. It's a bit weird. Alternatively, let's open up a terminal. And I press Ctrl Alt and T together and say sudo apt install Xane. This is another scanning program which, from my testing today, I noticed it's working very well with the scanner. So let's close this up. Let's quickly go to our files. And it should be here somewhere, yeah? If not, then I'm absolutely certain that my other method is better. So let's rather wait for this one. Xane is already installed. So then we go Xane. Yes, please. And as you can see, it's scanning for devices now. If you don't know Xane, then that's okay. As you can see, normally because I've already installed it in the past, there were a few other things will also open up, but I closed them. And it just reinstalled it, so it remembered my designs, but then you can just, if you have things like this, you can just lock them all out. They have all these things, and you just close, and then you can say scan. If you're still looking, you're amazing. If you already know how it works, you're fantastic. I'm sorry that I'm not totally prepared. As you can see, this is my work computer. Running Linux Mint on this one, and I'm running Ubuntu on my other one, on my own PC. And here you can say save image, and you can save it in whatever way you want. So I like this method much more. And there you go. And you can And you can make more than one page if you want to. I think it's awesome, I think it's easy to understand, and thank you for watching, see you later, and goodbye.